County. I'm Carrie Hudson, and welcome to It's About You, an informational program about the classes, activities, and special events of the Williamson County Parks and Recreation Department. Well, as we sail through the summer and head into the fall here in Williamson County, the Williamson County Parks and Recreation Department has several special events and programs planned to help you enjoy the last of this summer weather, our outdoor pool season, and also some great outdoor recreation programs to pique the interest of young athletes across the county. Joining me for the first half of our show today is Lindsay Goolsby. She's a recreation specialist at the Longview Recreation Center at Spring Hill, and she's here to talk to us about their upcoming Australian Down Under Family Night event. Lindsay, thanks for joining us today.
Thanks for having me.
Now, I know Sarah Foster's been the one planning the majority of this event. We're really going to have to talk to her about the name of this event, because the Australian Down Under Family Night event is a really long time for me.
It's long.
But it sounds like it's going to be a wonderful night for the people in the south end of Williamson County to have a great family event for everyone to attend. You guys have a really wonderful pool at the Longview Recreation Center at Spring Hill, and it is probably one of the busiest. It is the most popular attraction at that location. And I love the special events that you guys do in the summer to pull that amenity into your programming for the community. Yes. You guys do a lot of great pool events. Like in the past, you've done Pool-a-palooza, where you've had outdoor battle of the band concerts on the pool deck. Just this summer, you had another family night event where you viewed the dive-in movie event, where you viewed the movie Hook. You've done Hawaiian and Polynesian luau's before, and it just goes on and on and on and on and on. I love your creativity and how you guys keep coming up with new kinds of events and experiences for the public. Yeah, it's an outdoor pool party, but you always try to put a little bit of a different spin to it to make it a new experience for the people in that community to participate in.
Absolutely. I mean, who doesn't want to go to the pool and watch a movie and be able to swim? It's just, it's something that's different and fun, something our kids love to do.
Exactly. And for people who maybe, when I grew up, we had a pool. Swimming at night is the best time to go
swimming.
The water's warm because the sun's been on it all day, but then you don't have all of the heat of the sun just like beating down over you.
Yes.
I mean, it's absolutely the best time to be at the pool.
Yeah, that's when everybody wants to go, especially the kids.
The kids always want to go to the pool. They could care less.
Yeah.
And you can tell I'm a parent now, because the first thing I think of is like, well, then, hey, we probably don't need a bath that night.
Yeah.
Like, they're getting wet.
Or no sunscreen. So that takes out a lot of the time.
Or no sunscreen. There's one battle I don't have to face that day.
Absolutely.
Well, let's talk a little bit about what you guys have planned for the Australian Down Under Family Night event. Talk to us about what you guys are going to do in conjunction with this special event, because you are actually going to be doing quite a couple of different things with this event.
Yes. It's August 23rd, so we'll come out, you can come into the pool, swim for a little bit, movie will start at sundown.
You guys are going to be watching Kangaroo Jack.
Kangaroo Jack.
Lovely kid
film. Yes, awesome. So then we'll have home barbecue and hot dogs for the kids, and then we also have Nashville's very own Nashville Kangaroo. The Australian football team will be coming out so they can mingle and meet and greet with them too. So that's going to be something that's really different, really fun.
Exactly. And it's a chance to kind of expose your kids and your family to something a little bit different.
Yeah.
For people who have not had the opportunity to participate in one of our outdoor movies on the pool deck at the Longview Rec Center, you definitely have to check this out. The Movie Mate screen and projector are just cool to see. It's this huge inflatable movie screen that thankfully we have the world's biggest pool deck out at Longview to accommodate. And it's just a different kind of experience when you can float in the water and watch a movie, on the big screen.
Yeah,
you know, we throw dinner in, so it's an all-for-one kind of event for the family that night.
Yes.
And then getting the opportunity to do something a little bit different with the Australian theme and actually have the Nashville Kangaroos come out and join us for the evening, you know, and teach the kids a little bit about Australian football and what that is, and you know, it could be something that your kids learn to really enjoy.
Interested in, absolutely.
Yeah. It will be a whole lot of fun. Like you said, dinner is included with this event.
Yes.
On the Barbie.
Yes.
In our Australian lingo.
Yes.
For the night, we do have an Australian barbecue for the parents, and then for the kids, we have hot dogs. You know, it's just one of those things that we kind of adapted with these special events. It's a separate kids' meal.
Yes.
There are a lot of young families.
Absolutely.
In the south end of Williamson County, and a lot of kids that come to the Longview Recreation Center and participate in our programs.
Yes.
And you just kind of get to know what the kids do
like.
And don't want.
Yes.
You know, and you're like, not every kid is going to probably do the barbecue, but what kid doesn't want a hot dog?
Hot dog.
Yeah, they hardly ever turn those down.
Yes.
So a little bit of a different alternative for the kids if they want the hot dog. And all around, it's going to be another fun night at the Longview Recreation Center. I just can't wait to see how you guys prepare the scene for this event.
Yes.
You have a very creative staff at the Longview Recreation Center.
Very, very.
And come up with some amazing decorations.
Mm-hmm.
The dive-in movie that you guys did this summer where you did the arch over the gate to the outdoor pool with the beach volleyballs and the inner tubes. And I can't wait to see what kind of Australian-themed decorations you guys are going to be working on for this event. It'll be something for people to really enjoy.
It's going to be very festive. Obviously, stick to the theme. It's going to be great. We're working really hard to get a lot of different stuff going and to make it really nice.
And fun for everybody.
Yes.
Well, like you said, this event is coming up on Saturday, August the 23rd. Again, it is going to be at the outdoor pool of the Longview Recreation Center. The event is from 6:30 to 10 p.m. And the outdoor pool will close a little bit early to the public that day at 3:30 p.m. so that our staff has time to decorate and prepare for the event. This is a special event for the entire family. Children under the age of 12, though, must attend with at least an adult that's 18 or older. And of course, like every time our pool is open, we will have lifeguards on duty for the safety of all of our participants involved in the program. The cost of the program?
$6.
Yeah,
$6,
right? We always
cannot
talk about
it.
The affordability of our programs and how we work hard to keep them affordable for people.
Absolutely.
I mean, just with, you know, my one child, I mean, I know sometimes when we plan to go out, you know, it can be a really big expense.
Mm-hmm.
And the fact that you get a great night out for your family with entertainment and dinner for $6 a person is amazing.
You can't beat it. Mm-mm. You cannot beat $6.
Absolutely not. Children 1 and younger are free.
Yes.
Let's face it, children 1 and younger aren't really going to be eating a hot dog or barbecue or anything else like that. And then the next most important thing that people need to know about this event is how they can get registered.
Absolutely.
Registration for the majority of our special events is always required so that we have adequate time to prepare and plan to properly staff and run the event.
Absolutely.
Registration begins at 10 a.m. on Monday, August the 4th. Space is limited for the event, and if you would like to check on availability or to register your family, you can contact the front desk at the Longview Recreation Center at 615-302-0971, extension 2210. And a member of our staff at the front desk will help get you signed up for this event. Payment is due within 5 days of your registration. And there are no floats or rafts permitted with this event, correct?
Of course. Flotation devices, that's a totally different thing. Those are allowed.
Flotation devices for young children, but
no rafts, floats, it's just a safety thing.
Mm-hmm. Issue thing, absolutely. All right, and then some wonderful community sponsors.
Absolutely.
There are some amazing businesses that have partnered with us for year-round sponsorship of a lot of our special events.
Mm-hmm.
And you guys have three sponsors in the south end of Williamson County who have signed on as year-round special event sponsors for everything that you do at the Longview Recreation Center. And today we want to thank Elite Physical Therapy, the Children's Academy, and Sport Clips for their dedication and their year-long sponsorship of all the programs that we do at the Longview Recreation Center. Not just with this one event, but everything
all
throughout the year.
We couldn't do it without them.
That is exactly true. Without their help and without their assistance, a lot of these events wouldn't be possible.
No.
You know, I talk to people a lot, you know, throughout the day with my job, and they're always amazed at the level of programming that we do, that we offer as much as we do.
Yes.
And a lot of that goes back to being able to partner with good community businesses yes. that can help us produce these mm-hmm. this level and number of events yes. for the public. So for their help, we are always yes. continually grateful. And again, our Australian Family Night event is coming up on Saturday, August the 23rd. It is from 6:30 to 10 p.m. at the outdoor pool of the Longview Recreation mm-hmm. Center. For more information, you can visit our website at www.wcparksandrec.com. You can visit the Longview Recreation Center at 2909 Commonwealth Drive in Spring Hill. That's in the Wakefield subdivision next to Longview Elementary mm-hmm. School to get some information there. Or you can get information in a monthly newsletter from any of our Williamson County Parks and Recreation facilities. Not only will you find out about this event, but yes. you'll find out about a lot of great programs, special events, ongoing classes that everyone in your family could participate in. The variety is endless yes. with what we do.
It is.
It really, really is. Well, Lindsay, I want to thank you for coming in and joining us today. It's been a pleasure to talk to you.
Yes.
I wish you a ton of luck and success with your Australian Family Night.
Thank you.
When you find out what Australian football is, you come and let me know.
We will. Absolutely.
I think it'll be great. But you guys have a great time. Have a lot of fun, and hopefully we'll see you again soon.
Thank you so much.
All right, y'all stay tuned. When we come back, we'll be talking about more upcoming special events with the Williamson County Parks and Recreation Department.
Come on out to this year's Williamson County Fair, August 1st through the 9th, to celebrate our 10th anniversary. There will be plenty of activities, including pageants, 4-H events, performances by Sean Clush and Cody Ray Slaughter, the return of Grand Ole Country Night, and much more. Tickets for adults are $6, tickets for children ages 6 through 12 are $3, and anyone under the age of 6 gets in for free. Make sure you come out to this year's Williamson County Fair. This is an experience you don't want to miss.
Light was leaving in the west, it was blue. The children's laughter sang, skipping just like the stones they threw. The voices echoed across the waves. It's getting late.
Welcome back to It's About You. We're talking today about some of our fall special events with the Williamson County Parks and Recreation Department. And for the second half of our show today, we are joined with Randy Ann Sears. She is the Fitness and Wellness Coordinator for Williamson County Parks and Recreation. She is here to talk about her upcoming youth triathlon event mm-hmm. called the Half Pint Triathlon.
That's right.
Well, Randy Ann, first, thanks for joining us today.
Thanks for having
me. It's great to have you in here to talk about this event. A couple weeks ago, we talked with Gary Hathcock about some of their upcoming athletics programs, and we talked about the Fins and Feet Aquathlon. Which getting him to say that is quite funny. But in talking about that event and in things that our department's doing, has been doing for a couple years now, like your Half Pint Triathlon mm-hmm. and the Mighty Tykes Triathlon, multi-sport events are really getting very popular and are really starting to be something that a lot of people in this area are starting to participate in.
Yeah, it is. I wouldn't even call it a trend. It's just people have begun to realize that they have a lot of different interests, and why overextend yourself in like a longer event with that's one sport when you can combine all three and you give yourself and your body a different type of workout, different type of experience.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And I love how we have taken things like this and we have made them adaptable for children, because I know it's something that I've seen in my own life. If you find something that you're passionate about and you start doing it when you're young, you'll enjoy it for a lifetime.
Absolutely. And then you see, you know, kids are, they're resilient. It's just amazing what they're capable of.
Mm-hmm.
But a lot of times as a society, we don't give them enough credit. So you see it a lot in sporting events or, you know, any type of event where these kids are taking basic skills that they just love to do.
Because they just love to be outside and run.
They do.
They just love to be outside and ride their bike.
Run, swim, and bike. Like, you put them together in an event, and it's it's game.
Yeah.
Let's do
the
it.
The next thing you know, you're like, you know, buddy, you're doing a triathlon. You know?
Yeah.
You're like, yeah, I can do that kind of stuff. It's a really good confidence builder for kids, I think, too. You know, I know when I was growing up, I didn't consider myself to be an athletic kid.
Sure.
My sister was, and she was the athlete in the family, and she could play all the sports, and she played softball and basketball and everything that they offered in our little community. I didn't see myself as being athletic. But the great thing about some of these multi-sport events is it's not really geared around a sport per se. It's just, like we said, kids doing stuff that they do outside. They ride their bikes, they run, they swim.
Yeah.
You know?
And it's the community experience where they're around kids their own age, and they're all trying to obtain the same goal of just finishing.
Mm-hmm.
So, which is amazing. I think it's just a wonderful event, and you get to see the look on these kids' faces. And that feeling of accomplishment when they cross that line. So,
well, talk to us a little bit about the structure of this event. This is it's based off of the approach of a traditional triathlon. We've kind of scaled it down for children to participate in. This event is geared for children ages 8 to 12. But tell us how you've structured the event and what kids will be doing during the course of the half-pint triathlon.
Sure, absolutely. You know, it's just really a replica of what an adult triathlon. It's a swim, bike, run. And we have just broken it down into smaller portions. So, you know, obviously a child's body is not made to endure longer in distances, much like an adult. So we've just broken it down into very obtainable goals for these kids. It's just like it is with an adult. You know, you have a pre-registration, you have a packet pickup, which is full of a lot of information and just goodies that kids are excited about. There's always a t-shirt and a finishing medal because they see that as what they're achieving rather than like a place.
Right.
And then, you know, the day of the event, you're coming and you're getting your timing chip. We've got Race Day Events that comes out and they time this event for us, but they do it in a very technological way. You know, you've got the chip that is computerized so that when they're crossing these different points in the race, it kind of gives them an idea of what their speed is. So the kids will get that. They'll have transitions, which is the point of where they're, you know, moving from one event to the other. And then the finishing line is, you know, set up just like you would see in, you know, major events. You know, it's a huge blow up and there's music, and there's a gang of people waiting to just, you know, place that medal over their head when they're finished. So it's what you would call a sprint. It's a really quick event. They're not really going long distances, but it's enough where they feel like they've accomplished a lot.
Well, and from ages 8 to 12, you know, that's a 4-year age gap, but there's a lot of physical changes that happen in kids within those ages. So you've got two different age groups that you work with for this event. You have juniors 8 to 9, and then you have seniors from 10 to 12, and each of them actually participates at different distances or intervals in the competition. Kind of outlay for us each of the divisions and what distances they bike, swim, and run for the
program. Okay. So with our 8 and 9 year olds, our juniors, they're going to swim 50 meters, which in our outdoor pool is a down and back. And then they'll transition, they'll get on their bikes. For our junior division, they're going to be biking a mile and a half, which is two laps, I believe it's two laps of our walking trail that's back on Fulton Greer. Once they finish that, they'll hop off their bikes and then they'll run. Our juniors are running half of a mile. I believe that's right. I'm sorry, I don't have the exact.
Half mile.
So that's really about probably between 15 and 20 minutes of the actual event. All of the swim starts are based on where they're at, if they've participated before. So our more advanced swimmers are going to be starting first. So everybody, you know, all of the people that cross the finish line are not really in the same finishing times. So you don't really know where your competitor is on the course if you're looking at a finish time. So it's really great to see, you know, all these kids that are, you know, they have a common goal. They want to cross the finish line.
That's it.
And then our senior division, we have a 100-meter swim, which is actually four laps. So it's a down, back, down, and back. Again, it's based on what they have rated themselves as swimmer, if they're more advanced versus, you know, just the beginner swimmer. And it transitions into a 3-mile bike and then into a 1-mile run. So all of the running is an out and back. So when they finish the race, you know, the spectators will get to see them start the run, and then there'll be a portion where they're just going to be cheered on by our staff and volunteers. Mm-hmm. Just because of the course, the way it's structured. And then when they're finishing, of course, all of the spectators are going to be able to see their kids crossing that finish line and be able to greet them.
So. Great. And because there is such a wide age range with this mm-hmm. event, each child will race as of their age on race day.
Right.
And every participant's required to bring a bicycle, a helmet, mm-hmm. obviously safety first, and the appropriate clothes for the segments of their race.
Right.
They'll need something to swim in, and then they'll need the additional things, shoes and whatnot for biking and for
right.
running.
Absolutely.
And then like you said earlier, each child also receives a t-shirt mm-hmm. and a medal for their participation
yes.
in the half pint triathlon.
Yes, they do.
And then in addition to that too, you guys are also going to be giving awards to the top overall competitor in each of the age divisions.
That's right. Top finisher will receive a generous gift certificate from Sports Seasons to go in, get gear, get new shoes, whatever it is that you might like. So. We're always excited to have the opportunity to sponsor or partner up with mm-hmm. our sponsors.
So. Absolutely. Well, let's talk about the event itself.
Yeah.
It's the third annual Half Pint Triathlon. It's coming up on Saturday, September the 6th mm-hmm. at the Franklin Recreation Complex. Again, it is for children ages 8 to 12. And like you were talking about earlier, there is some advanced packet pickup with this event. Tell us about those details
sure.
and kind of when people come the day of the race, when your transition meeting and all that kind of stuff
sure.
is.
Sure. Registration is open and it's still continuing. Once you've registered, you're kind of in the waiting period until mm-hmm. The day prior to the event when we give them opportunity to do pre-packet pickup. They can come and get their bib number that they'll have to run through the biking and running segment. And then other goodies, and then they'll have their race t-shirt. Some choose to wear that during the race, but it's obviously not a requirement. That will be available on Friday prior to September 5th, between 3 and 7 o'clock. You can come and pick that up. And the reason that we give them that opportunity is because the race is an early morning race.
Right.
So we open up
check in
at 6:30 a.m. the next morning. So a lot of parents don't really want to get up earlier than they have to on that Saturday morning.
Sure. 6:30 is early enough.
Yeah, it is. So we give them an opportunity to do it the night before so they can kind of get their mind around where they want to place their bib, you know, just kind of get ready.
Get ready for the next
yeah,
day.
Absolutely.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
And then on race day, September 6th, like I said, you have check-in at 6:30 mm-hmm. a.m. You have a transition meeting at 7 a.m.
Mm-hmm.
And that's just kind of walking through each of the transition phases
right.
with the participants and both their parents, one of their parents.
Yeah, we just
kind of
huddle
pick?
Up and we just kind of tell them, you know, what transition is. At that point, we close transition. So that there's, you know, nobody's coming in and out of a place where you've really got all of your gear, you've got it set up, you've got your bike strategically placed so that you can hop on it and run out. And we just don't want people in there and kind of disrupting the organization of it. So we just huddle up and we talk about what the game plan is. We do have a start time for the juniors. And then the seniors will just be kind of...
When they finish.
Yeah. It'll be starting up within a few minutes of finishing. We are aware that there are parents that have kids in both the junior and senior, so we want to give them an opportunity to get back so they can equally cheer on their older
right.
child as well.
Participating for both.
Yes,
exactly.
Absolutely.
And then your start time for the junior events is 7:30
yes.
a.m. The cost to participate in this great multi-sport event is just $20 per
mm-hmm.
participant. It's the same for a junior or a senior.
Right.
That covers their entry fee into the event, that covers their t-shirt and their finishing medal. And it's a great cost for, like, you know, a one-day event for a kid.
Yeah, and the cost is very reasonable, mainly because we're not a sanctioned event. We are a smaller event. Sanctioned events usually open it up to such a wide variety of competitors. And we want to give this an opportunity for those kids that have never done it before,
mm-hmm.
A little more comfort zone for them, where they don't feel like it's at that height of competition. Because it's not exactly what we want it to focus on, but we do realize that some of our participants are there to compete.
Are there to compete.
Yeah,
absolutely. Well, like you said, registration is already open for this event. Space is limited, though, and it's available on a first-come, first-served basis. Until basically the program is full.
Yeah.
You can take up to 100 athletes for this program. A payment does have to be received. Is it within 5 days of registration?
Yeah, typically the way the registration is, it's a mail-in registration. So once we receive it, the payment has to be with it. That's what we consider securing the spot.
Right. Yeah. Right. And then tell people how they can get the registration forms and how they can get signed up
for
the event.
We have registrations available at all of our facilities. So at our main facilities of Longview, Franklin, Indoor Sports Complex, Fairview, and I believe there may be some registrations that are at our Crockett Indoor Arenas and places like that. So those are hands-on and available. Mm-hmm. All of the same information is posted online. If you go to our website of wcparksandrec.com, keyword half pint, you'll find those registration forms. It's just a PDF that you can print out. And then there are additional forms online that you can go ahead and print out so that you're not having to complete those at packet pickup or on race day.
Mm-hmm. So. Go ahead and get those taken care of.
Yeah.
Well, like with our other events, we do have a great list of community sponsors that have stepped up to help us produce this event for the kids. You've mentioned already race day events, who are doing the timing for the event. Sports Seasons, that's donating our top overall prize. We have Whole Foods, Smoothie King, the Nashville Striders. They've been doing this with you since you started the event 3 years ago. ASAP Awards, the Children's Academy, Star Physical Therapy, Cigna, Sonic, Chick-fil-A, McDonald's, Embassy Suites, and Culver's.
Yes.
I mean, it's an amazing amount of support that you've received for this event.
Yeah, it's fantastic. We could not do these type of events without the community sponsorships.
It's very important for everything that we do. And real quick, just to touch on it, you do have some special triathlon training sessions that you're doing to help prepare these kids for the Half Pint Triathlon. Your training sessions are already in progress, but we'll go over the remaining dates that you have. They're going to be on Thursday nights at 6:30 p.m. July 31st, you have a swim, bike, and run training session at the Indoor Sports Complex in Brentwood and Tower Park. August 7th is a bike and run session at the Franklin Recreation Complex. August 14th, a swimming session at the Longview Recreation Center at Spring Hill. August 21st, a swim, bike, and run session at the Fairview Recreation Complex. And then 2 days before, on September the 4th, you have an actual race simulation that you'll be doing at the Franklin Recreation Complex where the Half Pint Triathlon will be held. So there's really a lot of opportunity between now and the race for kids to kind of get acclimated to some of what's involved in this triathlon.
Absolutely, because that's what most of the hesitation is, not knowing what to expect. So we want to give them full opportunity.
Wonderful. Each of these sessions does require advanced registration. They are only $5 a piece. Like we said, all of the sessions do begin at 6:30 p.m. And if you would like to register for one of these training sessions, you can contact Randy Ann directly at 615-790-5719, extension 2011. Randy Ann, good luck with this. It's
Thank
a wonderful
you.
Event. I know you guys will have a great time. But best of luck with it and the other programs that you're working on for our department. In closing, we do want to reiterate the dates for our upcoming special events. We have the Longview Australian Family Down Under Family Night event at the Outdoor Pool on August the 23rd. And then Randy Ann's Half Pint Triathlon is coming up on September the 6th. In closing, we do want to remind you about a couple of other programs sponsored by the Williamson County Parks and Recreation Department. The Williamson County Fair is coming up August 1st through the 9th at the Williamson County Ag Expo Park. We want to invite you to visit our department booth, visit with our staff, pick up a free monthly newsletter and some promotional goodies, and find out about all of the great amenities and activities that we have to offer to the community. Also want to remind you that beginning on Friday, August the 8th, our outdoor pool schedules do change. Pools will only operate on the weekends from that point, on Saturdays from 10 a.m. to 6 p.m. and Sundays from 1 p.m. to 6 p.m. through the remainder of our outdoor pool season, which will wrap up on Sunday, August the 31st. Also at this time, several of our programs and our divisions are planning for fall activities, and there are a lot of open registrations going on now. If you would like more information, again, you are able to pick up a free monthly newsletter at any main Williamson County Parks and Recreation location, or you can always visit us online at www.wcparksandrec.com. I want to thank you guys for joining us for today's show. We'll see you next time. And until then, remember, Williamson County, it's all about you.